فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى, this is going to be our final part in the explanation of the book أسماء الصحابة التي اتفق فيها محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري ومسلم بن الحجاج بن مسلم القشيري رحمهم الله تعالى ومن فرد به كل واحد منهما دون صاحبه. Written by الإمام الحافظ أبي الحسن علي بن عمر الدارقطني رحمه الله. Last session we stopped at حرف الفاء. So باب الفاء, we're going to carry on from now. باب الفاء اتفقا في الفضل بن عباس. So Bukhari and Muslim, they both agree on the narration of الفضل بن عباس, who is a brother of who? Abdullah ibn Abbas. Rather, he's the oldest brother of Ibn Abbas. And you see, and Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib used to be called what? Abu al-Fadl. You see, وَأُمُّ هَانِ وَاسْمُهَا فَاخِتَةَ بِنْتِ أَبِي طَالِبِ. From those who Bukhari and Muslim agree upon is أُمُّ هَانِ, but her name is فَاخِتَةَ. فَاخِتَة is her name. بِنْتِ أَبِي طَالِبِ. وفاطمة بنت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ورضي الله عنها. البخاري ومسلم both narrated, they brought the narration of who? فاطمة, the daughter of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. وانفرد مسلم, and also if Muslim is alone in the narration of who? فضالة بن عبيد وفاطمة بنت قيس. وفاطمة بنت قيس. فضالة بن عبيد and Fatima bint Qais, or more like Fatima bint Qais, her story is the what? Fatima bint Qais is the woman who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she said, Ya Rasulullah, two individuals are asking for my hand in marriage. Who are they? Muawiyah and Abu Jahm. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, as for Muawiyah, he said, فَسُعْلُوكُ لَا مَالَ لَهُ. He has no money. Don't marry him. As for Abu Jahm, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, ضَرَّابُ لِلنِّسَى. He hits the women a lot. In another riwayah, the Prophet ﷺ, he says about him, لَا يُلْقِي الْعَصَىٰ عَنْ عَاتِقِهِ. The stick is always on his shoulder. He's carrying his stick. He doesn't take it from his shoulder. In other words, he hits the women a lot. He hits the women a lot. Bukhari narrated from him in the narration 5,322. Al-Imam al-Bukhari, رحمه الله. As for Imam Muslim, he did not narrate Fatima bint Qais fi musnadihi, in his musnad, in his hadith which are musnada with its chain. He didn't. What I tried to do was I tried to look for the hadith of Fatima bint Qais in Sahih Muslim. I did not find it in there. So maybe it could be my shortcoming. But it seems to me personally that Fatima bint Qais, her narrations are not in Sahih al-Bukhari. They are in Sahih Muslim. And that is what Darqutni said, which is correct. As Darqutni said, I tried to verify that, and it's true that she's not in Sahih al-Bukhari. But the story is mentioned there, without her name mentioning. باب القاف اتفقا في حديث قيس بن سعد. They both agree. Bukhari and Muslim both agree on the narration of who? Qais ibn Sa'ad. They both agree on his narration. وَانْفَرَدَ مُسْلِمْ. But Imam Muslim is alone in the narration of who? بِقُطْبَةِ ibn Malik. وَقَبِيسَ ibn Mukhariq. Both of those, they are only found in Muslim. As for Bukhari, he's alone in قُدَامَةِ ibn Mad'un. قُدَامَةِ ibn Mad'un. Who's a brother of who? Uthman ibn Mad'un. وَقَتَادَةِ ibn Nu'man. قدامة ابن مضعون is who? Qudamah ibn Mad'un is the individual, the companion, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who drank the alcohol. And he didn't just drink alcohol. He actually said it's halal for him. And then Umar radiyallahu anhu found out. Umar said, bring him to me. So they brought Qudamah ibn Mad'un to Umar radiyallahu anhu. Umar said, hey, you're not just drinking alcohol. You're actually saying it's halal. How does that work? He said, didn't Allah say in the Quran, لَيْسَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ جُنَاحٌ فِي مَا طَعِمُوا إِذَا مَتَّقُوا. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, there is no burden upon the one who comes with piety, what he eats or drinks. It doesn't matter. If he comes with taqwa. Didn't Allah say that in the Quran? Umar radiallahu anhu said, yes. He said, why does it matter what I eat or drink if I've come with piety? I'm a companion of the Prophet. Umar radiallahu anhu said, shall I explain the ayah for you? He said, yes. He said, the ayah came down for a group of companions who used to drink alcohol before alcohol was made haram. And they died whilst alcohol wasn't prohibited. And we started to ask the Prophet, once the alcohol became haram, and the rulings and the severe punishment were mentioned to us, we said, what about those who died before the ruling came? And it was then said to us, لَيْسَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ جُنَاحٌ فِي مَا طَعِمُوا إِذَا مَتَّقُوا. Because they were before the ruling. But it's not referring to a person right now. And that's the importance of the sabab. Sabab al-Nuzul. Knowing why the ayah came down. Umar radiallahu anhu then, when Uthman ibn Mad'un found this, when he found out, he repented. But the repentance does not remove the what? The punishment. Umar still lashed him. For drinking the alcohol, the 80 lashes is still there. As for the takfir, it wasn't placed on him. It wasn't. وقتادة بن النعمان رضي الله تعالى عنه باب الكاف اتفق في كعب بن مالك. The Bukhari and Muslim both are together on who? كعب بن مالك. Just so you know, Qudamah ibn Mad'un, he was from من شهد بدر. He was from those Sahabis who participated in Badr. And Umar radiallahu anhu, he used him when he sent him to Bahrain. And Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he did not narrate him in his Musnad. Qudamah ibn Mad'un, he didn't narrate him in his Musnad. In the hadith which are Musnadah. Babul Kaf, ittafaqa fi Ka'b ibn Malik. They both narrated from Bukhari and Muslim, both of them narrated from Ka'b ibn Malik. وكعب ابن عجرة كعب بن مالك, you know who he is. وعلى الثلاثة الذين خلفوا حتى إذا طاقت عليهم الأرض بما رحبت وطاقت عليهم أنفسهم وظنوا أن لا. This ayah came down on him, and it's when he stayed away from the battle of Tabuk. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated from كعب بن مالك and also كعب بن عجرة. وانفرد مسلم, and Imam Muslim is alone on the narrations of who? أبي مرثد. That's his kunya. His name is كناز ابن حسين العلوي. He's a Badri, participated in the battle of Badr. وَأَبِي يَسَرْ كَعَبْ بْنُ عَمْرْ وَكَعَبْ بْنُ عَاصِمْ أَبِي مَالِكِ الْأَشْعَرِي. This كَعَبْ بْنُ عَاصِمْ, he's not the other أَبِي مَالِكِ الْأَشْعَرِي that Imam Muslim Bukhari رحمه الله تعالى done the tashkik between him, أَبِي عَامِرْ الْأَشْعَرِي and Abi Malik al-Ash'ari. They're two different companions that shouldn't be confused with one another. Babul Lam, the Lam letter now. Akhraja Muslim, an Imam Muslim narrated from who? Ummul Fadl wasmuha Lubabah. Ummul Fadl, her name is Lubabah. You will find her in Sahih Muslim, but you won't find her in Sahih al-Bukhari. That's why Dayrequtni says, وَلَمْ يَخْرُجْ لَهَا الْبُخَارِيُّ شَيْئًا. And Imam al-Bukhari did not narrate anything for her. And Imam al-Bukhari, Abu al-Walid al-Baji, he didn't accept that from Imam al-Dayrequtni. He says in his kitab, Imam Abu al-Walid al-Baji, rahimahullah, in his kitab, الجرح التجريح والتعديل. He mentions, قال الشيخ أبو الحسن انفرد مسلم بالإخراج عن أم الفضل لبابة ولم يخرج لها البخاري شيئا وأراه نسيا. He says, I think he forgot. Look how the good interpreter thought that he had of him. But she is صحيح البخاري. نعم. She has a riwaya and a narration in Sahih al-Bukhari. Naam. Rather, Imam al-Bukhari narrated from her in two places. Naam. Babul Mim. The letter Mim now. Man ismuhu Muhammad qad dhakarnahu fi awwali ma dhakarnahu. Dar al-Qutni says, we're now going to move on to Mim. But we're not going to mention the names that have Muhammad in it. The reason is because he actually started with who? The Muhammad at the beginning. And his name was who? Muhammad ibn Maslama. The reason why he started his name with the Muhammad at the beginning is because this is the name of who? The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. اتفق في مالك بن الحويرث ومالك بن ربيعة. They both agree upon Bukhari and Muslim narrate from who? مالك بن الحويرث ومالك بن ربيعة whose name is أبي أسيد الساعدي ومالك بن صعصعة والمسور بن مخرمة ومحمود بن الربيع. And Imam Muslim didn't bring Mahmud ibn al-Rabi'. He did not bring him in his ahadith which are musnada. Also, sometimes scholars ask you a tricky question. He was the youngest companion, Mahmud ibn al-Rabi'. He's the one who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam squirted in his face with the water that the Prophet had in his mouth. He squirted it on his face. And he's a little kid. So the way they found that he was a companion was that he mentioned, he said, when I was young, the Prophet squirted water on my face. That showed that he knew, he was aware of what the Prophet did to him. He was the youngest companion. Naam. Wa Mushaji' ibn Mas'ud. You see, wa akhuhu Mujalid. And his brother Mujalid. Wa Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Wa Musayyib ibn Hazan. Wa Mughira ibn Shu'ba. ومعيقيب ومعقل ابن يسار. And we took who معقل ابن يسار, right? It was نعم. ومقداد ابن عمر الأسود تبناه. وأبو عمر ومعاوية ابن أبي سفيان وميمونة بنت حارث. Those are who they agree upon. They all differed upon who? They all differed on Muslim, for example, he narrated from معاوية ابن الحكم ومطيع ابن الأسود and who? والمستورد الفهري. الإمام البخاري رحمه الله didn't narrate from those. وانفرد البخاري بالمقداد بن معدي كرب. As for الإمام البخاري, he's alone on the Sahabi whose name is المقداد بن معدي كرب. You know, معدي كرب is from the أسماء which are known as what? تركيب مزجي. It's like تعبط شرا أو yeah? Like حضر موت for instance. It used to be حضر موت, صح؟ Became one word now. It's called, in the Arabic language, it's called what? It's called a tarkib masji. ومرداس الأسلمي ومعن ابن يزيد السلمي ومروان ابن الحكم. All of those Bukhari narrated from them and Imam Muslim didn't narrate from them. That's bab, that's meme. نون اتفق في أبي برزة نضلة ابن عمر الأسلمي. And it's also said Ibn Ubaid, Nu'man ibn Bashir al-Ansariyu. Al-Nu'man ibn Bashir al-Ansariyu. Other scholars, they say, scholars, they differ on his name. Some call him Nufay', and others don't. Nawfal ibn Muawiyah, Nu'man ibn Muqarrin, Nusaybah wa Mu'atiyah al-Ansariyah. Muslim is alone on who? Binafi' ibn Utbah wa bin Nawas ibn Sam'an wa bin Usaybah ismu rajulin. He's trying to distinguish between Umm Atiyah al-Ansari and who? Nusaybah, who is a male. Babul Wawa. We're going to now go into the letters Waw. اتفق في أبي جحيفة واسمه وهب وفي واثلة بن الأسقع. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated from who? أبي جحيفة whose name is وهب and واثلة بن أسقع. وانفرد مسلم بإخراج وائل بن حجر. الإمام مسلم رحمه الله is alone in the narration of who? وائل بن حجر من رواية ابنه علقمة بن وائل وحده عنه. And the only person who narrated from him is son علقمة بن وائل alone. And Wa'il ibn Hujr, رضي الله تعالى عنه, his narrations, 90%, or the only narration I've personally come across, was the narration of what? The salah. The sifatun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how he prayed. It revolves around Wa'il ibn Hujr. رضي الله تعالى عنه. Also, the one who Imam al-Bukhari became alone on is one person, is Wahshi ibn Harb. Wahshi ibn Harb. Babul Ha. We're now going to move on to the Ha letter. اتفق في أبي بردة هاني ابن نيار وفي أم سلمة بنت هند وأم سلمة هند بنت أبي بنت أم أمية, who is the wife of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. The wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أم سلمة. هند بنت أبي سمية. Sorry, هند بنت أمية. بنت أبي أمية. So Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, both of them, have narrated from Burdahani ibn Niyar and Umm Salama, whose name is Hind binti Abi Umayyah, who is the wife of the Prophet ﷺ. And Muslim is alone on the narration of Hisham ibn Amir, also Hisham ibn Hakim. And Imam al-Bukhari, he narrated from Hisham ibn Hakim in the story that is well known, the story of when Umar radiallahu anhu had a khilaf and difference with Hisham ibn Hakim in the issue of the what? Qira'at Surah Al-Furqan, remember how it was recited? Naam. Babul Ya, which is the last letter. Ya is ittafaqa fi Ya'la ibn Umayyah. Ya'la ibn Umayyah, Bukhari and Muslim, both of them are together on. We've now finished the story, the narrations of the companions who Bukhari and Muslim both agreed upon, or one is singular on from the other. We're now going to move on to Babul Kuna, the kunyas. Ittafaqa fi Abi Jaham ibn al-Harith. They both came to narrate from Abu Jaham ibn al-Harith wa Abi Bashir, and also Abi Bashir. Wa anfarada Muslim bi Abi Habba al-Badri. Also, Muslim is alone on who? Abi Habbah al-Badri. وانفرد البخاري بأبي يعلى وانفرد البخاري بأبي سعيد بن المعلى. And we've already spoken about who? Abi Sa'id ibn al-Mu'alla. We spoke about him when we were speaking about the letter Ra. وأبي داود. And also who? Abi Dawood. His name is Abu Dawood al-Mazini al-Ansari al-Badri. Bab al-Nisa al-Makniyat. Now we're going to go into the women whose kunyas have been mentioned in Sahihain, or in one of the two. Ittafaqa, they both agree upon Ummu Sulaym wa Ummu Kalthum bint Uqbah ibn Abi Mu'ayyad wa Ummu Atiyah wa Ummu Qais bint Mihsan wa Ummu Sharik وأم حرام بنت ملحان وانفرد مسلم بأم مبشر وأم الحسين وأم هشام بنت حارثة أخت عمرو وانفرد البخاري بأم رومان وأم خالد بنت خالد ابن سعيد وأم العلاء وأم السليط. As for أم سليم, who we've mentioned her name, we mentioned her الرميصاء, صح؟ When we were in the chapter of Ra. Umm Kalthum bint Uqba, we mentioned. Umm Atiyah, her name was what? Nusayba, right? We just took her now when we were talking the letter Noon. Umm Ruman, her name was what? Her mention was in Sahih al-Muslim, right? She's not in Sahih al-Bukhari. Na'am. Unfarada Muslim. Na'am. Imam Muslim is alone on her. Mm-hmm. He says, no. He says, one farad al-Bukhari bi Umm Ruman. And Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, mentioned her story. When Aisha, radiallahu anha, remember when she was getting married. The story of Aisha, radiallahu anha, when she was getting married. Who prepared her? Umm Ruman did. And her mentioning, her tajheez, her preparation for the marriage was mentioned by Umm Ruman. So this is Sahih Muslim. نعم أم العلاء أم العلاء also she's in Sahih Muslim. She's from those people who gave the Prophet ﷺ the bay'ah, which is in Sahih Muslim. أم السليط رضي الله تعالى عنها الإمام البخاري he didn't bring him in his Musnad. ولا من رواياتها شيئا he didn't mention any of her روايات الإمام البخاري. But she's mentioned about Umar radiallahu anhu when he was talking about the battle of Uhud. Who was the one who dug the graves for the companions? It was Umm al-Ala. Naam. Sorry, Umm al-Salit, sorry. Umm al-Salit radiallahu anhu. فهذه جملة ما خرجاه جميعا من حديث الصحابة من الرجال والنساء رضي الله عنهم في كتابيهما جميعا. So those are the companions in which Bukhari and Muslim have narrated from, whether it be the men or the female, and their kunyas. في كتابيهما. And we conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I said was wrong or a mistake, فإنه مني ومن الشيطان والله ورسوله بريئان منه. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.